नमस्ते चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर दैट इज अडॉप्टेशंस इन डिफरेंट प्लांट्स वेयर इन द एलपी वन वी केम टू नो अबाउट डिफरेंट वैरायटीज ऑफ एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स, एलपी टू वी केम टू नो अबाउट इंसेक्टिवोरस प्लांट्स, नाउ इन एलपी थ्री वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट नॉन ग्रीन प्लांट्स. Generally, plants means we see that green color because the leaves of the plant that are green in color, which help for photosynthesis process and they're preparing food material. Yes. But now we are going to learn about non-green plants. Means now the plants are not having any chlorophyll in them. There is no chlorophyll in these plants. So if there is no chlorophyll in these plants, if there is no chlorophyll in these plants, then how the plant it is preparing its food material and how it survives, that we are going to learn in this today's module, that is your non-green plants. Okay, so now in this module we will come across few keywords like parasitic plants. The first one is your parasitic plants, PARASITIC, parasitic, PLANTS plants. First one is your parasitic plants. Now the second keyword, that is your hostoria, HAUSTORIA, hostorias. The third key one is your mycoheterotrophic plants, MHPs, MYCO, myco, HETERO, hetero, TROPHIC, trophic, PLANTS plants, mycoheterotrophic plants. And the fourth one is nutrients, NUTRIENTS, nutrients. So these are the few keywords that we will come across in our today's module. One is your parasitic plant, second one is your hostoria, third one is your mycoheterotrophic plants, and the fourth one is your nutrients. Okay, so before starting the class, let's have a small activity. Children, observe the picture, observe this picture and two more pictures I will show you. Observe these pictures carefully, carefully observe these pictures. This is a picture of one plant where the root is yellowish in color and the leaves are completely whitish in color. This is one plant, this is another plant, this is another plant, this is the plant that is your dodder. This is a dodder plant. Okay, this is your Indian pipe. Okay, and now this is one more plant, snow plant. So observe these three pictures again carefully, children. One is your dodder plant, second one is your Indian pipe, third one is your snow plant. So after observing these three pictures carefully, and even in your textbook one more picture is given, this is your Rafflesia. Observe this Rafflesia also very carefully. So after observing these pictures carefully, we will come to know one conclusion. Let us tabulate that conclusion. So now in the table, you divide the table into four boxes. So in the first box, copy down the first question, that is, how are these plants different from other green plants? So after your clean observation of these three or four plants, can you please tell me how these plants are different from the other plants? The first difference is other plants are green in color. They have a specified roots, stem and roots. Okay, so now these plants, they are completely in different colors with a no clear differentiation into root, stems and this one. See, what special features help them to get their nutrients? So their roots are there. In a green plant, if you will see, roots, stem, leaves, like the different structures we will observe. But whereas other green plants, just now you had seen these pictures, in these pictures, you won't see any such different roots, stems and leaves. Yes, now they were asking what special features help them to get the nutrients. What special features that will help them to get the nutrients? How they will get the nutrients? As we are saying that it's a non-green plant. So if it is a non-green plant, now in these plants, The common feature that we will find is they don't have chlorophyll in them. Okay, so now if there is no chlorophyll, there is no photosynthesis. So now how these plants, they will get their nutrients? So to understand this question, now let's have a small look on a video. Okay, children.
Parasitic and mycoheterotrophic plants lack chlorophyll. They depend on other organisms for their food. Parasitic plants get nutrients from their host plants. Mycoheterotrophs get nutrients from fungus.
So children, after observing that video, we came to know that these plants, one of the non-green plants, we are saying it as a parasitic plant. What we are saying to that plant? We are saying to that plant as a parasitic plant. So parasitic plant, it is a type of plant where the plant, it is depending on the other plant. If one plant, if it is depending on the other plant, then it is called your non-green plant, parasitic plant. So these parasitic plants, not even depending on the other plant, they are even sometimes damaging the other plant. That's what we are calling them as a parasitic plant. So now the other plant which is giving shelter to this parasitic plant, it is called host. Like if relatives will come to your house, you are giving shelter to the relatives, so you are called as a host. So now the other plant which is giving shelter to this parasitic plant, it is called the host plant. So now these parasitic plants, they are depending on the host plant completely for nutrients purpose. So now how they will get it? So here in this screen, you are able to see some small yellowish colored tender like structures that are encircling the host plant. So these yellowish color structures, those are the modified roots. Where is this picture? Yes, these are the modified roots that are seen in the parasitic plants. So the modified roots in the parasitic plants that are called your hostoria. What we are calling to these modified roots? In a parasitic plant, the modified roots, generally roots means present inside the soil, and they are brownish in color. But here the roots of parasitic plants, that is your hostorias, they are present outside and they are yellowish in color, and they are completely encircling the host plant. And these roots, with the help of this hostoria, now the parasitic plant, it is absorbing the nutrients completely from the host plant. Even in parasitic plant also, you will see two different structures. One is a complete parasitic plant. A complete parasitic plant. And a partial parasitic plant. So we are saying parasitic plant means it is a non-green plant. It is depending on the other plant for food material purpose. That plant which is giving shelter, it is called your host plant. So now such a parasitic plant, with the help of these hostorias, these are the hostorias, with the help of these hostorias, they are absorbing the nutrients. So now these hostorias are called the modified roots in the parasitic plants. Such a parasitic plants are of two types. One is a complete parasite and the second one is partial parasite. So complete parasitic plant means throughout its life, it is depending on the host plant for nutrients purpose. And in return, it will damage the host plant. It will kill the host plant. So complete parasitic plant, throughout its life, it is depending on the host plant, taking the nutrients from the host plant, either causing damage or totally killing the host plant. Now the second variety, it is your partial parasitic plant. So the partial parasitic plant, it is taking only nutrients and water from the host plant, and it will try to prepare its own food. So partial parasite means only for few substances like nutrients and water, it is depending on the plant body, and it is preparing its own food. So partial parasite, we will say. So parasitic plants are the first non-green plants that we will come across in our today's lesson. That is your one best example is your dodder plant. So in a parasitic plant, the modified roots, we are calling it as a haustorias. So with the help of these haustorias, now the plant is completely encircling the host plant. It is completely encircling the host plant, taking the nutrients from the host plant and causing damage to the host plant. Okay, so now another type of plants that you will see here, which are whitish in color structure here, that's your Indian pipe. Another one, if you will see, it is a snow plant, it's pink in color. So both are non-green plants, no? So these type of plants, either in Indian pipe or a snow plant, these type of plants, we are calling them as a MHP, mycoheterotrophic plants. Same, they don't have chlorophyll in them. They cannot prepare their food material. So now for food material purpose, they are depending on the fungus. They are depending on the fungus for food material purpose. And now this fungus, it is growing on the decomposing material, dead material, decaying material, means spoiled items. So now the fungus is taking nutrients from the dead materials and MHPs are growing on the fungus. So MHP directly not taking the material, what nutrients from the decaying material. It is taking the nutrients from the fungus, from the mycelium of the fungus. So we are calling such plants as a MHP, mycoheterotrophic plants. Heterotrophic means dependent. For what material, for what purpose this Indian pipe or snow plant they are depending? For the food material purpose they are depending. And myco means mycelium, which is a part of fungus. So on the fungus, some plants are depending for food material purpose. So we are saying such plants as a mycoheterotrophic plant. In a short word, we are calling them as a MHP. Indian pipe is one such good example of MHPs, and even your snow plant is also one such example for MHPs. That's what you can able to see. It's almost growing on the waste parts where a small microscopic fungi is growing there. And these plants, they are getting nutrients from such fungi. Okay, children. So now it is about your worksheet. So in your textbook, open page number, page number 14. Open page number 14 from your textbook. Let's see the first question. Tick the non-green plants in the box. Hibiscus plant. Is it is green or non-green? So non-green, don't touch it. Dodder plant, it's a best parasitic plant. So tick there, it's a non-green plant. Indian pipe, of course, it's an MHP. So it is also a non-green plant. And Rafflesia, this is your Rafflesia. Yes, this is also a non-green plant. So tick dodder plant, Indian pipe and Rafflesia. So now let us move to the second question. Look at the picture and fill the table. The first picture is your Rafflesia and the second picture is your Indian pipe. So what are the similarities between these two plants? So here they are writing, asking you to write one similarity between the two plants. So the one similarity between the two plants is both are non-green plants. Both are non-green plants. Now the third question, if you will see in this only, in the second question, second block, if you will see, write how they differ to get their nutrients. Write how they differ to get their nutrients. In Rafflesia, it is a parasitic plant. It gets its nutrients from the modified roots. Whereas Indian pipe, it is getting nutrients from the fungus. Rafflesia, it is a parasitic plant. It is getting nutrients from the host plant with the help of haustorias. And your Indian pipe, it is a MHP which is getting nutrients from the fungus. Okay, children. Now, the third question, if you see, how do parasitic plants affect the host plant? How do the parasitic plants affect the host plant? So, the haustoria of the parasitic plant, it will encircle the host plant deeply penetrate into the host plant's stem, absorbing the nutrients from the host plant and causing damage to the host plant. How do the parasitic plants affect their host plant? Means the parasitic plants having a modified roots called hostorias, which are encircling the host plant, deeply penetrating into the stem of the host plant and absorbing all the nutrients from the host plant and causing damage or even killing the host plant. Okay, children. So after completing this worksheet, you are having page number 20 from your volume book. Page number 20, practice questions are there. So in that practice questions, the first question, if you will see, yes, the first question, if you will see, let's see here. Yes, so the first question, that is your circle the plants that do not have chlorophyll. Circle the plants that do not have chlorophyll. So the first one, your Rafflesia is the answer and Indian pipe is the answer, because these two are the plants which do not have any chlorophyll in them. So now the question, second question is, how are parasitic and mycoheterotrophic plants different? Parasitic plants are the plants which are getting nutrients directly from the host plant. Mycoheterotrophic plants are the plants which are getting nutrients from the fungi. And now the next one, write two harmful effects of non-green plants on their host plant. Two harmful effects of the non-green plants. The first harmful effect is, non-green plants are depending on the host plant and absorbing the nutrients from the host plant, so that host plant nutrients will get decreased. And even a parasitic plants, they are even causing, they are killing the host plant. That is another harmful effect. Okay, children. So the second and third questions you will get in your classwork. Go through the lesson, complete your worksheet and practice questions. Okay, children. Thank you so much.